Okay, so what does Google Pay and Fi Money have in common? They both come from the brains of two Indian entrepreneurs, Suchit and Sumit. Both played key roles in the success of Google's digital wallet and online payment system. And in May 2019, they both founded the neobank Fi Money. And given how successful Google Pay has been, I mean it's now used by 8 out of 10 Indians when paying for stuff, I'm really excited to review Fi Money and see what they have to offer. We'll also look at how Fi compares to India's leading neobank, Niyo, to see who has the best travel card and savings account. Fi is partnered with India's Federal Bank, and that's where your money would be deposited. This partnership means you get all the banking privileges provided by Federal Bank, including deposit insurance up to 5 lakh. Now, as of February 2022, Fi Money has over 1 million users, and they've reported that those users make an average of 15 transactions per month, which is significantly higher than the industry's average of 4 to 5. So it's clear that there is already a very large number of users trusting this platform. And in November 2021, in a fundraising round led by Facebook's co-founder, Eduardo Saverin, they raised $51 million. This demonstrates significant investor faith and trust. So knowing all of this, along with a deposit insurance and guarantee of up to 5 lakh, I think it's safe to say that we can trust Fi Money with our money. Fi is currently only available to working professionals, eliminating students and any non-salaried individuals. And this is verified during the registration process using your credit score or company details. And I think this is immediately a downside to the account. And Niyo Global, unlike Fi, is available to all types of people, including students. If you're eligible and you do sign up for this account, then you will receive the following. A zero balance savings account with 2.65% interest that you can deposit money into via UPI and any other banking methods. You'll get access to fixed deposit and minimum term savings accounts of up to 5.95% interest, zero foreign exchange markup or fees on international transactions, free ATM withdrawals from Federal Bank ATMs, a free Visa debit card, personalized insights and spending analytics, the ability to invest in mutual funds, which is basically like investing in stocks and shares, savings features known as smart deposits and jars, a checkbook, demand draft option, and more interesting features which I'll mention at the end. This account is also free to open and has no minimum balance or maintenance fees. Although to get the full experience of everything this account has to offer, including rewards, you will need to actively deposit money into it as well as spend and save that money. While Niyo Global doesn't charge an account fee, they do require you to deposit a minimum of 5,000 rupees to receive their card. They also charge 249 rupees plus GST to replace it. While Fi doesn't charge you for your first replacement card, they do charge 250 rupees per card after that. Also, before I go any further into fees, I just want to mention that all of the following require an additional GST fee, which right now is 18%. So, as I mentioned already, ATM withdrawals from Federal Bank ATMs are free with Fi. This is similar to Niyo and their free ATM withdrawals from SBM Bank ATMs. Also, both Fi and Niyo offer 5 fee-free ATM withdrawals each month from non-federal and non-SBM Bank ATMs. So, they're very much equal on that. Once you exceed your monthly withdrawal limit, Fi will charge you 21 rupees per withdrawal and Niyo 20. For international ATM withdrawals, both Fi and Niyo charge 100 rupees, so around 118 with GST. Of course, this is as long as you don't withdraw money from an ATM that charges fixed fees. And to avoid this, when you're abroad, try to use an ATM at a physical bank branch. And another quick tip, when you do withdraw money abroad, always decline the currency conversion at the ATM. That way your bank, or in this case, Fi Money and Visa, will take care of the foreign exchange for the withdrawal. There are some other fees that both Fi and Niyo charge, including surcharges at petrol pumps, and I'll link their fee pages below under relevant links. However, these are typically the most important ones to be aware of, and besides the fact that Niyo requires a minimum deposit to receive their card, they are both pretty equal. One downside to both Niyo and Fi is that you can't send money internationally, and while traditional banks such as Federal and SBM Bank may offer this, They also typically charge fixed fees and hidden fees in bad exchange rates. So to avoid this, next time you send money to another country, use Monito.com. You can enter your country, where you're sending the money to, and how much, and our comparison engine will tell you who the cheapest and best provider will be. It's free, it won't take a minute, and it might just save you some money. Speaking of saving money, Fi have positioned themselves as a money management tool that rewards their users for not only spending, but also for saving. They not only offer a zero balance savings account with 2.65% interest, but you also get access to higher interest products through Federal Bank, which Fi calls Smart Deposit.
That's run in partnership with an RBI approved bank. A Fi savings account actually makes saving easy. Create a Fi jar to save for the things that matter to you. The money you put in here goes into a smart deposit.
You just deposit the money and select a maturity date, which impacts the rate of interest you receive. And the further away the date, the greater the interest you'll earn. You can also close a smart deposit and withdraw your money at any point, although there is a pre-closure fee, which is 1% of the interest rate. When it comes to earning interest with Niyo, the percentage you can earn will depend upon the balance in your savings account. And this could range from balances up to 2 lakh, earning 3.5%, all the way to balances over 5 lakh, earning 5%. With interest starting at 3.5%, Niyo does have the better savings account. However, with Fi and their smart deposits, you can potentially earn more interest while depositing less money. If you're not bothered by the restrictions of fixed period interest rates, or perhaps you don't have as much as 5 lakh to immediately earn 5%, then you could argue Fi is superior to Niyo's global account, especially considering their travel card benefits are practically equal. But in Niyo's defense, they don't advertise this card as a savings product. It's meant as a bank account for international travelers that can also earn a little interest on the side. The Fi Money app comes with a number of additional features, including AskFi, Fit Rules, Fi Rewards, connected accounts, and mutual funds. AskFi is a tool to help you navigate the app. Think of it as a smart FAQ section.
So, how much money? 10. Every time I hit a 6.
Yeah, man, that's the deal.
It's not what you're thinking. It's 5.
Fit Rules are an automatic way to deposit money into your smart deposits. If you're like me and you love cricket, then you could have a Fit Rule set 10 rupees aside when your favorite IPL cricketer hits a 6. These can be a unique and fun way to save money, and Niyo and their global card don't offer anything like this.
Here's a presentation on how using Fi can be rewarding. Create a travel jar, and boom, you get a reward. Save with Fit Rules, boom, another reward.
Then there's Fi Rewards, which you can acquire through not only spending, but also saving money. These rewards could be cashback, extra money deposited into your smart deposits, or even Fi Coins. This is their virtual currency that you can redeem for physical goods and gift vouchers. For example, Fi recently rewarded anyone that saved 5,000 rupees during the IPL season with a hamper that they sent to their home. They also have a connected account feature, which allows you to sync your other savings accounts with your Fi Money app. Finally, you can use Fi to invest in a number of different ways, including those mutual funds which I mentioned earlier. You can actually create a Fit Rule to invest the money into a fund. So for example, whenever you order on Amazon with Fi, you could have the app automatically invest 200 rupees, and you can also select from a number of different funds, which are all simply outlined in the app. To get access to mutual funds, you'll need to be a full KYC account holder. This stands for Know Your Customer and is a standard banking practice to help banks verify your identity. And this will all be done during the registration and account opening process. If you do have any difficulty registering, Fi has both email and phone support, which is great. And of course, once you're registered, you get access to in-app support. Niyo has all of this as well. And actually, when I reached out to both companies while researching for this video, they were both really quick and helpful. Good customer support isn't the only good thing they have in common. Their international travel fees are very similar. They have fee-free transactions. They both use Visa's exchange rates, and their ATM withdrawal fees are equal. For savings though, in my opinion, Fi is superior. Although Niyo has the greater basic savings account interest, they don't offer anything like Fi's smart deposits or Fit Rules, which are totally unique and a cool and fun way to make saving money enjoyable. If I was a working professional in India, even if I I wasn't looking to use Fi money as a travel card, I would still consider opening an account. And if I did need to travel, it would likely be the card I would use internationally. Hope you found today's video useful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Let me know if you have a Fi money account or if you're going to open one, as I'd love to hear from you, especially because I can't actually open an account because I don't reside in India. If I did though, I most certainly would. Namaste.